You know, Father, 2021 is almost in the books, and 2022 is right around the corner. I was thinking, why don't we take a drive from Solvay to Lakeland, from St. Cecilia's to Our Lady of Peace, and take a drive down memory lane and look at what's in the future for our church.
Good idea, Adam. Let's go.
How many times do you think you've made this drive from one place to the other?
Wow. Maybe.
Well, let's think about it. If we just talk about weekend masses, mm-hmm. and weekday masses, we don't count funerals, weddings, baptisms, holy days of obligation, Christmas, Easter. That's four masses every week, and we'll average it and say three every weekend.
Sure.
That's almost, if I do my math, carry the one, factor in pi, 2,600 masses in the 7 years that you've been our pastor.
Wow, 2,600.
And if you think about it like this, it's 3.3 miles from one location to the next. And if you do the math on that, that's almost as many miles that you've driven just to do daily and weekend masses. That's as far as Kate and my kids and I drove when we moved to Syracuse from Arizona. That's pretty incredible.
It's a long drive.
And one of the things that I think is really great that we've managed to really do as a parish is put behind the model of having to just be a neighborhood parish. We are a community parish, we're a territorial parish, we're serving more and more people, and we're serving more and more people than just our neighborhood and our territory, because hundreds are joining us every weekend online.
It's a whole new concept that we've managed to embrace through creativity, through the strength of our faith. Our faith has led us to discern from the Holy Spirit that we couldn't use that old model anymore, that we had to become bigger.
That's right.
And better at communicating the gospel.
Absolutely right. You know, it's really interesting that we start thinking about how to grow when so many churches aren't thinking about how to grow. So many churches are thinking about if we could just go back to the way that things were.
Yeah.
And it's so interesting that we have that, so many people have that mentality, when Jesus talks so much about going out, spreading to all people, bringing that good news to so many, and putting aside these fabricated ideas of what our church community is supposed to be like. And we've totally embraced that. And that's a huge hope for me going into 2022 and beyond.
Me too. Every time I drive this route from Solvay to Lakeland and Lakeland back to Solvay, I think to myself, this is a big territory. I've been entrusted with the pastoral care of all these people, and that means that I'm supposed to proclaim Christ to them. Mm-hmm. We're trying to do it in a different way than we did in the past, and we've stopped saying we've always done it that way, mm-hmm. which is defeat. Mm-hmm. That's death. Mm-hmm. But we're alive and anticipating with great hope this new calendar year.
That's right. And I think one of our big hopes for this next year is moving into a new season of invitation, of being a welcoming and inviting parish community that shows people that you can have radical hospitality and beautiful liturgy, Orthodox preaching, bringing the truth of our Catholic faith to our neighbors and friends. And we want you to join us in being radically hospitable this 2022.
Absolutely. Jesus said, the kingdom of God is in your midst. It's here. Embrace it. And that's got to be our attitude. The world is filled with negativity, but what makes us unique as the Church of Christ in the face of the greatest evil, the greatest disasters, the greatest tragedies, Christ says, yes, I will fix it. From all of us at St. Mary Ann Cope Parish,
to all of you and everyone that you love,
we pray that you have a blessed and happy new year.
And we can't wait for you to join us in 2022.